Hello friends, today's our topic is MacPlatun. MacPlatun is a great heroic poem by John Dryden, the representative poet of the Restoration Age in England. He wrote it in 1678, but it was published anonymously in 1682 as Dryden's response to Sadwell's criticism on him. The Restoration Age was the era of great political upheavals in England. The men of letters rivaled each other owing to the political parties they loved. Sadwell was on the side of the Parliament, while Dryden took the side of the royals. The ultimate result is the War of the Worlds. It was John Dryden who started this literary war with the publication of his great satirical poem, Absalom and Ahithophel. He criticized the opposite party, Thomas Sadwell, as his response to Dryden's literary attack, published his poem entitled The Medal of John Bayes. Sadwell made Dryden the target of his criticism in his medal. And this particular attempt resulted in the publication of MacPlatun on the part of John Dryden. It means that John Dryden's MacPlatun is John Dryden's response to Sadwell's poem, The Medal of John Bayes. MacPlatun is Dryden's brutal attack on Sadwell. The name MacPlatun is typical. Mac means son. Plekno was a name of the person. MacPlatun means the son of a Plekno. Plekno is almost a synonym of stupidity. Dryden, by presenting Sadwell as the son of Plekno, mercilessly ridiculed Thomas Sadwell here. The poem is interesting one. The poet's scheme of retaining a lofty style of expression for the insignificant subject is worth noting. Do read the original text, you will enjoy it. Let's concentrate on the MCQ of the MacPlatun. Number 1. Which of the following is true to MacPlatun? Options are A. It is mock heroic poem by John Dryden. B. It was first published in 1682. C. It ridicules Thomas Sadwell, contemporary poet of Dryden. D. All these are true. Correct option is D. All these are true. Number 2. Which of the following is true to MacPlatun, a poem? Options are A. It is subtitled A Satire Upon Two Blue Protestant Poet Figures. B. It is composed in heroic couplets. C. It is biting satire on Thomas Sadwell. D. All these are true. Again, the correct option is D. All these are true. Number 3. In MacPlatun, the poem, Platun has been presented as the king of dashes. Options are A. Rome, B. Augusta, C. Norwich, D. The realm of nonsense. Correct option is D. The realm of nonsense. Number 4. Plekno's rule is compared to the design of Dashas. Options are A. Augustus, B. King John of Portugal, C. Ascanius, D. Hannibal. Correct option is A. Augustus. Number 5. Flecknoe chooses dash dash as his heir in the poem entitled Mac Flecknoe. Options are A. Selwyn, B. Hume, C. Shelley, D. Ogilvy. Correct option is A. Selwyn. Number 6. Who of the following is the last great prophet of tautology? Options are A. Hume, B. Shelley, C. Fletcher, D. Thomas Sedwell. Correct option is D. Thomas Sedwell. Number 7. Flecknoe chooses Sedwell as his heir for Dashdas. Options are A. A prophet tells him to do so. B. Sedwell is the wisest of all his sons. C. Sedwell is his only heir. D. Sedwell stands confirmed in full stupidity. Correct option is D. Sedwell stands confirmed in full stupidity. Number 8. Dryden's Mac Flecknoe presents Dashdas as the stupid. Options are A. Sedwell, B. Hume, C. Shelley, D. All of them. Correct option is D. All of them. Number 9. Identify from the following the place of coronation ceremony of Thomas Sedwell. Options are A. Close to the wall of Augusta, B. Aston Hall, C. Bunhill, D. Barbados. Correct option is A. Close to wall of Augusta. Number 10. As Mac Flecknoe puts forth, Dashdas had prophesied long ago the rise of Sedwell as the scourge of wit. Options are A. Johnson, B. Fletcher, C. Decker, D. Shelley. Correct option is C. Decker. Number 11. Mac Flecknoe presents Ogilvy as Dashdas of Sedwell. Options are A. Brother, B. Cousin, C. Uncle, D. Distant relative. Correct option is C. Uncle. Number 12. As Mac Flecknoe, the poem claims Dashdas had come to prepare the way for Sedwell. A. Hugh, B. Shelley, C. Augustus, D. Flecknoe. Correct option is D. Flecknoe. Number 13. Identify from the following the native place of Thomas Sedwell. Options are A. Augusta, B. Norwich, C. London, D. Coventry. Correct option is B. Norwich. Number 14. Who of the following has sung for King John of Portugal? Options are A. Flecknoe, B. Sedwell, C. Johnson, D. Dryden. Correct option is D. Dryden. Number 15. Whom Dryden hails as the commander of the host in Mac Flecknoe? Options are A. Sedwell, B. King John of Portugal, C. Ascanius, D. Hannibal. Correct option is A. Sedwell. Number 16. Sedwell is consecrated with Dashdas. Options are A. Lawrence, B. Wreaths, C. Poppies, D. Marigolds. Correct option is C. copies. Number 17, at the moment of formation, dash dash hover over Sarvan's head. Options are A, 12 eagles, B, 12 vultures, C, 12 crows, D, 12 owls. Correct option is D, 12 owls. Number 18, who of the following addresses the Almighty on the occasion of Sarvan's coronation? Options are A, Sarvan, B, Plekno, C, Ogrivai, D, the priest. Correct option is B, Plekno. Number 19, the walkway of the coronation ceremony of Sarvan was covered with dash dash. Options are A, Persian carpet, B, Norwich dread jet, C, rich and colorful mat, D, writing of the worthless poets. Correct option is D, writing of the worthless poets. Number 20, who of the following anointed Sarvan on the auspicious ceremony of coronation? Options are A, the holy priest, B, Plekno, C, Ogrivai, D, none of them. Correct option is B, Plekno. Number 21, Sarvan's act of swearing is compared to the swearing of dash dash. Options are A, Ascanius, B, Arion, C, Romulus, D, Hannibal. Correct option is D, Hannibal. Number 22, which of the following poem by John Dryden opens with the lines given below? All human things are subject to decay, and when fate summons, monarchs must obey. Options are A, Macbethno, B, the Maiden, C, Absalom and Achitophel, D, Religio Lysi. Correct option is A, Macbethno. Number 23, as Dryden thinks, the genius of Sarvan lies in dash dash. A, satires, B, elegies, C, tragedies, D, anagrams. Correct option is D, anagrams. Number 24, in which of the following poem we get the lines given below? Like mine thy gentle numbers feebly creep, thy tragic muse dew smiles thy comic sleep. Options are A, Macbethno, B, the Maiden, C, the Hind and the Panther, D, none of these. Correct option is A, Macbethno. Number 25, what does Plekno leave behind for his son at the end of the poem? Options are A, crown, B, scepter, C, shoes, D, mantle. Correct option is D, mantle.